This chapter has a lot of tone, it's kind of like chapter four, which was like a crazy chapter. Chapter is the same thing, it's got a high cost, all the things that play. What happened we talked about, chapter 12. Okay, so I'm gonna highlight probably the thing that you're gonna use the most. For those special ones, organic chemistry, okay? And that has to do with solubility. So we're talking about making solutions, we have solutions, we talk about homogeneous, which means the same throughout. There's some terms here which I expect to know, which is solubility.
Over time, they expand and they can crack the teeth and
more. Anyway, air is only solid.
Fun fact of the day.
A couple terms, soluble and insoluble.
Like first feelings, I didn't need that today.
No, they can give you the new kind of filling that like look like your teeth color. Uh-huh. Go with that if they, you know.
But those don't work.
Okay.
But they don't expand and crack your teeth open.
Mixing.
It's like, you know.
Happens spontaneously.
That's just.
Okay, mixing happens spontaneously. We'll talk about why here. So I have some water, and I have some sodium chloride over here. I remove this, and suddenly it becomes uniformly the same concentration
every
time. And that happens spontaneously.
Sucks.
The answer is why. Why does mixing happen spontaneously? Well.
White vein.
There's a thing in the universe called entropy, okay? There's a thing in the universe called entropy. And entropy is, well, if you want to get physics-y, is the number of microstates achievable by a substance. So let's get real. Entropy is the ways in which something can distribute energy, okay? Entropy is the number of ways something can distribute energy. It's a pretty important concept. The number of ways something can distribute energy. The more ways that it can distribute energy, the lower energy it is. The more ways it can distribute energy, the lower energy it is. that enters the substances.
Because if you isolate it, obviously it's going to have...
Do what?
If you isolate it, it's going to be a higher energy rate.
No, we're just talking about taking it and changing it so that it can distribute energy more ways. And I'll talk about what I mean by that here in a second.
They
so
go
let's take... the more ways you distribute energy, the lower energy you are. Sodium chloride. Okay, sodium chloride. It's an ordered structure. Repeating DNA pattern. We call it what?
The more ways you can distribute your energy, the lower energy you actually are.
You've got a crystalline structure, repeating geometric pattern. Is that a very ordered system? Yes. Order is high energy. Anything that has order in it is high energy. Now, I take something like sodium chloride, I throw it in water. Is it a crystal anymore? What happens to sodium chloride when it goes in the water? It turns into individual ions, right? So solid, high order, high energy goes to something that's aqueous. Does it do this spontaneously? I think the sodium chloride goes with water and spontaneously turns into an ion. Why? Because now it has more ways of distributing energy because it has movement. Okay? These sodium chloride molecules can now move around and figure out different ways of distributing energy. Doing that lowers its energy. So, solutions many times occur because they're trying to mix. Mix is lowering or increasing your entropy, i.e. the ways you can distribute energy. So mixing increases entropy. You know this. Mixing increases entropy. The number of ways that you can distribute energy. So mixing increases entropy. So over here, we have so many ways that these molecules can orientate themselves and distribute energy. They have a pretty good mechanism for distributing because they're liquid and they have movement. Do you think they'd have more ways or less ways as a gas? The answer is more ways because there's more. These are all close together, right? They can only go so far. With a gas, it's wide open, right? So as a liquid, they have quite a bit of ways of distributing energy. But now when I mix these, they get more combinations in order to distribute energy. This entropy is commonly called the measure of randomness disorder. It's kind of the measure of disorder. It's kind of like I'm going to chop some wood. You have two choices. I can stack it, or I can just throw it in a pile. Which one takes less energy? That's entropy in play right there. And that's what molecules will do every single time. They will go to disorder instead of order. They go to disorder because of entropy. Entropy lowers the amount of energy. So there's a law in the universe called the second law of thermodynamics. You don't need to know this. The entropy of the universe is increasing constantly. In fact, energy in the universe is constantly trying to spread out. Eventually, it'll be spread out so far the universe will just be dark. No light. Don't worry about it. The Earth would cave in the sun long ago before that happens. Okay.
Oh,
so
that's a relief.
A lot of organizations don't like entropy because it's kind of a pessimistic thing because everything's trying to go with the darkness and all this kind of stuff. They think, well, entropy is a lie because, for example, a plant grows. Is a plant more ordered or less ordered than when it started with?
It's less ordered.
Is it more complex and random, or is it more complex or more random when it started? It's more complex, right? And then the dirt and air, right? So actually, that's a decrease in entropy. So things are constantly decreasing also, but they're also increasing. But what's that compared to the sun? How much entropy is the sun absorbing? I'm going to answer a lot. It's going to disorder in a big way. It's number of microscopes. It's huge. How big is the Earth compared to, how big is the Sun compared to the Earth?
Humongous.
Pretty darn big, right?
And there's your answer.
So the entropy of the universe is generally increasing, causing more disorder, more ways of distributing itself. What I want you to focus on right now is mixing's happening because of entropy. And one of the reasons why it happens because of entropy. All right, so if I take two gases in two different chambers and I turn them, all right, I lift the plate so they can mix. Do they spontaneously mix? Why are they mixing now? How do you know? What are they, why are they mixing? What's our magic word today?
Entropy.
I have gas A, gas B. They mix with each other to increase the number of microscopes. Number of ways of distributing energy. Everything mixes spontaneously because of entropy. So that's a very important concept. Yeah. That's why stuff happens a lot. Alright. That's good enough today, my boys. I'll give you a call. This is
something. I almost got to get a gig not long ago.
Oh, really?